Have you ever wondered how the same game would look and play in different game engines? Well, I did, and I decided to make it happen. In this video, I am going to show you how I made Chrome's Dino game using 6 different methods. And trust me, it was not easy. I love making games and experimenting with different tools and technologies. If you are interested in game development or just curious about how games are made, this video is for you. And if you enjoy it, please don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. First, let's go through the methods I have used and the game I made. The game I made is Chrome's Dino game. It has infinite obstacles, infinite running, score and jumping, but it doesn't have crouching or birds. I have used Unity, MonoGame, which is not an actual engine, but is a framework, Love2D and Solar2D. I used HTML5, CSS and JavaScript to do it from scratch, and the game I used to create Dino game within it was Minecraft. Starting with Unity. Unity has the biggest community by far out of all of these engines. It has a lot of built-in features to help you build any game you want. It has an easy-to-use editor. It uses C#, which is an awesome object-oriented language, but it's very heavy, especially with Visual Studio, and it is not open source. I have used RigidBody for jumping in Unity, and to reset or jump, I used collision detection that is also available in Unity. Also, created a custom code to move ground tiles backwards to make it appear as we are walking infinitely. Also used the built-in function to create animation of our main character. As you can see, Unity helped me a lot with its built-in functions, but that was not the case with MonoGame. Before switching, let me show you how the game works in Unity. This is how we jump, and this is what happens when you die. Switching to MonoGame. MonoGame is a free and open source engine that allows you to create games with using C#, which is an awesome language, but MonoGame has almost no tools to help you out. It is slower than other engines except Unity, and it is slower only because it uses Visual Studio. It also was the hardest engine beneath them. I had to create custom code for nearly everything: animations, jumping, collision, ground moving. MonoGame is for people knowing what they are doing, and it definitely is advanced and not beginner friendly. A more reasonable engine for starters would be Love2D. Love2D is also a free and open source engine. It has a big and active community. They create plugins. It uses Lua, but adds a lot of object-oriented programming friendly features to it Lua. It is the most lightweight and fast engine in this list. Running the game or building the game happen instantly. It has a lot of built-in features to help developers out, even though not as much as Unity has. It uses Box2D for physics, which is also an open source physics engine. It has its own sprite sheet separator, animation creator, etc. I did not have to create custom codes for many things using Love2D. And this is how our game looks in Love2D. I scaled the image all of the images quite a lot, that's why it looks like this. It has a reset button and everything. Next, let's see Solar2D. Solar2D is very similar to Love2D. It's free, open source, and uses Lua. It doesn't have as big of community as Love2D, but it still has an active community too. It is very fast, just like Love2D. Love2D has kinda better documentation and tutorials, while Solar2D has less. Solar2D has a scene management system that does not exist in Love2D. Love2D has more built-in features such as physics, audio, graphics, while Solar2D relies more on external libraries and plugins for additional features. Now about HTML, CSS and JavaScript. They are the core technologies of web development. They allow you to create web pages and web applications that can run on any browser and device. HTML5 is the markup language that defines the structure and content of the web page. CSS is the style sheet language that defines the appearance and layout of the web page. JavaScript is the programming language that defines the behavior and interactivity of the web page. I had to create custom code for everything here too, but it was not much harder from MonoGame. Because of my personal choices, I didn't find working with JavaScript pleasant, but it is way more forgiving and beginner friendly than C# is. Now let's look at the game. So, using Minecraft was easier than all of them. Finding the commands due to Minecraft's community's large size was easy. Developing other aspects was easy too, since Minecraft has already implemented jumping, collision detection, obstacles, etc. The paper we are holding is called Score, and it represents our score. Other than that, I just died 2 times. This is how our game works in Minecraft. The redstone all around me is actually running the game. I left it around us intentionally because I think it looks cool. And that's all. Thank you for watching. If you liked the video, please like and subscribe. See you on the next one.